Hi dancers! So today we're here with Abi, and she's a soloist from Bali, Manila. She'll be showing us her way of how she darns her pointe shoes. And so let's get started, and she'll show us a few of her tricks.
So to get from your blank pointe shoe to your darned pointe shoe, you will need your cotton or crochet thread, a needle, a thimble, some scissors, and some masking tape. So I would double up my thread. So we're working with two threads at the same time. And we're going to backstitch an entire circle around the edge of the pointe shoe. So it takes some time, but you try to keep your needle close to the surface so it doesn't go into the glue, because it's really hard to pull out, but that's what your masking tape is. So we will start from, actually you can start from whatever corner, but I like to start from here because it's the hardest part over there. So, just needle through there. Oh, now I'm nervous. And then just a little bit. And I don't knot my thread, so. So there, it's fine. And then we're gonna backstitch, so go back to where you came from. I don't like to work with thread that's too long because it knots. Just a little tight. And then you just go along the edges. So make sure it's on the edge of the pointe shoe, not too far in, not too far out. See if it gets. Oh no, that's not stuck. So if it gets stuck, for example, like this, just stick my masking tape and I pull it. You want to take your time because sometimes when you pull the thread too hard, the thread breaks. Or I've ripped like the seam off the shoe before, so take your time. Okay, so I didn't knot, and this is why you don't have to knot, because you basically knot the entire way. So after you've done your circle, we are going to loop around one way. So I usually loop around maybe like this kind of way. Not that small, but I'll show you. So, just follow your circle. Okay, see, if this happens, just stop and tighten the thread so you separate it. There you go, tightens. And then maybe I go about this far. And then this far. So you do this all the way. I'm going counterclockwise first, so. I've seen people darn with like dishwashing gloves, so like their fingers don't get, and there's grip on there as well, so you can try that. But I'm fine with my thimbles. Okay, so this, we've come a full circle around, so it's kind of gone diagonal a little bit. But now, after we've gone to where we started, we're going to do the exact same looping, but the other way. So what this does is it creates a crisscross with the thread, and what it does is it makes the thread stand up better. So when you dance on point, it doesn't like squish back and fall flat. So we'll go back. So the way I go back actually is just, I find a gap in between the previous stitch. So there's a gap there. There's a gap there. There's one there. See? There's a crisscross.
And then you just go until you run out of thread. Okay, so we're kind of short on thread now. So what I do is I cut like there. Don't have to knot it because we're just gonna sew over it. Get new thread.
This is putting pressure on me.
Just nice and not too long. Let me pick it up from here. Maybe there. The last one. And then just keep going. It will flatten out. It's okay if you have like a tail sticking out, you can just trim that off later.
Counterclockwise and then clockwise. So that's altogether three steps. Now for me, I like to do another round counterclockwise and another round clockwise. So another set of crisscrosses. So this is our third circle around counterclockwise. And I'm going to do the last circle clockwise. So we're going this way to finish off the crisscross. Now my thread's kind of short, so same thing. Once it kind of runs out, just cut it and start a new one. You don't have to knot it.
That's it. And then to finish off, just find a loop somewhere. Maybe this one. And just knot it. That's it. Just keep it easy. After a while when you dance, that knot will just kind of like flatten into the shoe. So if you have any like loose ends, just chop it off. That's it. Ta-da!
So this is the shoe that I currently just darned. And they're very sturdy, and I'll explain the difference. So before this, I actually used to chain stitch my pointe shoes. So I think you can, so chain stitching is a technique of sewing. So I used to do this. So like lots of circles compared to this. And the difference is when you chain stitch, I will press the thread for you. See, it kind of flattens, like it's squishy. And what happens is, when after a while, it becomes this, and it doesn't work as darning anymore. It's too flat. Like, it doesn't help at all. It's just decoration after some point. So that's the reason why I changed to these stitches. So when before, I think I mentioned, you crisscross them so the thread sits up a little better. When you press these, they don't move. They don't budge at all. So it's nice and sturdy, and it should go the distance. And what I do as well is if my shoe is dead, I let it sit for a while, a month or a bit, I'll bring it out again and revive it by darning it once more. So maybe another circle or two circles, whatever you're comfortable with, but it should make the edges nice and stiff again so it's comfortable to center. So revival of shoes!
So that's it for today, and thanks Abi for showing us how to darn. Thank you.
these shoes.